There are two types of gym goers, those who just cannot do without air conditioning and those who tell you that things would be better off without ACs. Well, the debate has been here to stay, but we thought to settle it at once this time. Celebrity trainers say that you need to prioritize above all else is convenience. What matters the most is that you really get up and go out to work out. AC or no AC does not really make a difference. And when it comes to the impact that AC may have on your workout, the negative effect AC has on your end results is often too exaggerated. The end results do not vary much this way or that way. In countries with tropical climates and hot temperature, it is very hard to work out without an AC. In fact, working out without an AC in such hot temperatures is more harmful than working out with one. If you work out in a temperature that heats up your body too much, you can get breathless and unable to work out properly. You cannot exert as much as you must because your body is very heated. And what about sweating less in ACs? Well, sweating more has nothing to do with fitness or burning more calories. It is simply genetic. The number of sweat pores on your body is what makes you sweat or don't. So, contrary to the popular belief, sweating does not make you lose fat. Sure, you burn one or two calories, but wet t-shirt at the end of your workout is not a measure of fat loss at all. For most, working out in an AC gym is more relaxing to the body post-working out and during it. Whether your workout caters to fat loss, building bulk, building lean muscle, the AC gym is more relaxing any day. It just feels a little suffocating in a non-AC gym, that's all. So folks, we all need to chill when it comes to air conditioning in our fitness studios. What we just need to ensure is being convenient so that we can maintain our routine and making sure the air we breathe is not stale. If you like this video, make sure to thumbs up and subscribe my channel. For more videos, keep watching.